David here with Fig Boot on Pens, back again with another fountain pen review. Today I have for you a pen from the company Penlux, and that pen is called the Masterpiece Grande. Now, I've previously reviewed a Masterpiece Grande with what is called the Koi Blue material, but what I have for you today is a model called the Wave. What I'm going to do is go over the parts and features of the Wave, talk about what I care for and what I don't care for about it. I'll show some measurements, size comparisons, and provide a writing sample. Thanks go out to the good folks at Itoya, who are the U.S. distributors for Penlux, as well as Sailor and a few other brands. If you are not familiar with Penlux, it is a company based out of Taiwan. They have been creating private label projects for over 15 years, and in 2015, they decided to create pens under their own brand. I previously reviewed a piston filler I enjoyed for them as well, called the Metallic. And then I also previously mentioned I've shown you that Koi Blue material on the Masterpiece Grande as well. The pen arrives in this box. It has the Penlux logo on the front. Then the top lifts off, and we have a few things inside here. We have a certificate of authenticity. There is some instructions on how to use the filling system and properly fill the pen. And then there's something rather interesting. There are instructions that are printed on some translucent plastic that basically warn you against disassembling the pen, whether it be the piston or even removing the nib. That was a smart way to present this info, because presenting it in a unique fashion got me to actually look at something I would have typically maybe ignored. And when it came time to clean this pen, I would have attempted to remove the nib, something that clearly states you should not do. So it goes to show, you should always look at the documentation which arrives with your pen, just in case there's something like this very thing that you need to be aware of. So this was good communication design in practice from the company. And here we have the pen. This is the Penlux Masterpiece Grande Wave. Now, on different sites, I have seen this pen called the Sky Blue Wave, or Blue Wave, or just Wave. So if you're looking for this pen, be on the lookout for variants of the name. I've also seen one retailer describe this as a North American exclusive, and another say that it's a worldwide limited edition of 388 pieces. I've also seen one say that it's gold trim, and another one say that it's steel trim. Now, these details aren't the most important, but it would be nice to see some more consistency in the marketing, and I realize that that's mainly on the retailers and not the company itself. The pen is made from PMMA resin. PMMA stands for polymethyl methyl acrylate, which is a strong and rigid plastic often used for like a substitute for glass in products such as like shatterproof windows and skylights and aircraft canopies. The material can really vary on this pen. On the one that I have here, the cap is a little bit more blue with the white swirling accents. On the barrel, the white accents are a little bit more prominent. I've seen pictures of this pen with significantly less white across the entire pen as well. But in my opinion, all variations look really nice. There are some description on retail sites which describe this material as semi-transparent, but in the model that I have here, I really couldn't see any portions of transparency. Everything is pretty much opaque. This is an oversized pen. It has a classic cigar shape. The dimensions really work well for me. It's very similar in girth and size to the Mont Blanc 149, but it is a couple of millimeters longer in length. Let's take a look at the cap. It comes to a rather wide, rounded point. Then we have the clip band, and then the clip. The clip tapers down to a wheel. I've always been really fond of wheeled clips. I think they look really cool, and they typically function well. This one really works well with materials of varying thickness. The cap does angle up until the very end, where there is a fairly thin cap band with the company name Penlux. The cap tapers down slightly as it transitions to the barrel. The barrel is straight for about the first 2 inches before it tapers down and you reach a medium-sized band signifying the beginning of the piston knob, which comes to a rounded point slightly more tapered than the top of the cap. The cap twists off with 1 3/4 rotations, and underneath we have a number 6 stainless steel Yovo nib engraved with the Penlux logo. The first Penlux pen I reviewed, the metallic, it had a Schmidt nib. And then also the company logo has changed. On this logo, the line which comes down from the P is short and a bit stylized. I believe in typeface terminology, that's called the descender. In previous iterations of the logo, it was a little bit longer and the logo looked very similar to Platinum's. So I feel that this change was a good move. This nib is available for the Wave in fine, medium, broad, and 1.1 stub. And here's a look at the plastic feed. The section begins with a very slight flare. Coming in at just over 12 millimeters, it is rather girthy, which works for me personally. I prefer thicker sections. It transitions into the threads, which I don't find to be sharp or uncomfortable if your grip should rest on them. And then it transitions directly into the remainder of the barrel. The oversized pen is large enough to use unposted. While it doesn't post overly deep, it does post securely, and the cap does indeed post. I think it adds a bit of length to the pen, but it's not so inordinately long that it becomes a little bit burdensome. The cap is fairly light as well, so I don't feel it backweights the pen or throws off the balance. But I personally prefer to use this pen unposted. I mentioned the piston knob before, but this is a piston filler. I won't twist it right now because the pen is inked, but the piston knob is surprisingly smooth with very little tension. What I mean by that is that normally you can feel the tension of the piston knob as it makes its way up and down the interior of the barrel whenever you twist a piston filler. When first checking out this pen, I unscrewed the knob and it was so loose I kind of expected it just to come off like a blind cap. Because that's all it really felt like. I couldn't feel any tensions whatsoever. There's nothing wrong with that. It just surprised me at how smooth and effortless the piston mechanism operated. At authorized Penlux retailers, you will find this pen for $192. And I feel that the under $200 price point for this pen is a fair valuation. I love the size of the pen, and the material is eye-catching, and I don't feel that the swirling of colors is overdone. And I think that the variations of this material I've seen all look sharp. This is one of those pens where you won't exactly know what the material on your specific pen is going to look like until it arrives, but whether it is light on the white or heavy on the white, I feel folks will be pleased with either. Okay, now it is time for some measurements, size comparisons, and a writing sample. Here we go with some size comparisons for the Penlux Masterpiece Grande Wave. Again, I just wanted to show you a look at this material. And you can see here that on this particular one, the cap is a little bit more blue and the barrel is a little bit more white. And I will say that in brighter light, the white really shows up more. That under this light, it looks really white, but then under most situations, it doesn't quite look as white, at least to me. In regard to some size comparisons for some other rather large and girthy pens, this is what it looks like with a Mont Blanc 149. Here it is with a Sailor King of Pen. And then finally, here it is with a Delta Dolce Vita Oversize. And then here it is with a Lamy All-Star and a Platinum 3776. This is a Yamanaka. And then also here is a Montegrappa Montegrappa. In regard to some uncapped comparisons, here it is with that Mont Blanc 149. I feel the sections are very similar in size as well. And then here it is with the Lamy All-Star, as well as the Platinum 3776. Here we go with the writing sample for the Penlux. And this is the Masterpiece Grande Wave. And this is a broad stainless steel nib. And the ink I'm using today is Sailor J. gentle, blue black. This is what the ink looks like. It's a really nice blue black. I will say when I first got into fountain pens, I just only used black ink and I really wasn't into ink that much. And then I kind of delved into blue blacks. And so I do have a lot of blue blacks in my collection, and the Sailor one is one of my favorites. This is Pelican Edelstein Tanzanite, which has a little bit more of a sheen to it. And then here is one of the more popular blue blacks out there, which is Bungbox 4B. This is what the Sailor bottle looks like. I will say that while I love their ink, this bottle design is probably one of my least favorite bottle designs. Not just the looks of it. The looks of it are fine. It's just that it is so shallow that it is almost impossible to use with certain pens and with certain nibs. So I find myself having to decant the inks into other containers that I could actually use from time to time. So love the ink. I'm just really not a fan of these bottles. And here we go with the rest of the writing sample. This broad nib is very smooth. It's very pleasant and very nice. You're not going to get a lot of line variation. I was pushing rather hard, and it was pretty much the same as when there was no pressure on it at all. But overall, the flow is very generous on this nib in regard to reverse writing. It's a bit hit and miss. But in regard to some fast writing, the ink flow is really solid and it keeps up just fine. So here we have the Penlux Masterpiece Grande Wave. I will say that this pen really impressed me and that I really like the material. I really like the size of the pen. And then especially this broad nib that's on here is outstanding and performs very well. So kind of a combination of all of those things really makes it something that I feel is worth checking out. So until next time, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later.